Hello, anatomy friends, and welcome to station 25, where we're looking at the superior portion of the posterior compartment of the leg, so those big calf muscles. And so these are going to be, like I mentioned, the largest muscles associated with the leg. You are going to have two that you're going to have to be able to identify here. And the first, or the most superficial, is going to be the gastrocnemius. And you can see that its proximal attachments are actually up near the condyles, the medial and the lateral condyles of the femur. So this is actually crossing the knee joint here. So it can play a small role in terms of movements of the knee joint. And then you can clearly see two bellies of the gastrocnemius when you're looking at the posterior calf region or the posterior leg region. And then about midway down the calf, where these bellies of gastrocnemius end, this is where you start getting the formation of the calcaneal tendon or your Achilles tendon. But also forming the calcaneal tendon, you will have a tendon from the soleus muscle, which you can see here, deep to the gastrocnemius. So I'm kind of outlining the demarcation between gastrocnemius and the soleus. The soleus is deeper, it is flatter, and even though it's deeper, it's so wide that you can actually see it kind of peeking out from the gastrocnemius. That's more superficial. Its proximal attachments, the soleus proximal attachments, are going to be on the fibula and the tibia, so it does not cross the knee joint like the gastrocnemius does. And then once the belly of soleus ends, then you really get this kind of more narrow, but certainly thicker and very prominent portion of the calcaneal tendon. Because, as you recall, the calcaneal tendon is going to be a shared tendon of the gastrocnemius and the soleus. So you can see these where it's a little bit wider up here and then it really condenses, but it's still quite powerful in terms of attaching to the calcaneus. So that is the distal attachment. Okay, so those are the superficial muscles of the posterior compartment of the leg. And I think that they tend to be a little bit easier to identify, certainly, than the deep posterior compartment. And so make sure that you spend some time understanding the depth of these muscles. And I think from there, it should be fairly easy in terms of identification. All right. Thanks for your time here. I will see you at our last muscle station, station 26 next. Thanks.